Welcome back to another estrogen release video. I am Asia and I thought I would kick this video off with one of my favorite segments. I haven't done this segment in like a year and I just thought I would bring it back. So in order to tend to the cliche version of vlogging as well as provide you guys with decent content, I came up with this segment called Irrelevant Information.
I've been trying out this new workout and it low-key kills me, but I'm a survivor. I have a brand new vitamin regimen, and I feel great. I organized my seasoning cabinet, and I personally feel like I can breathe better. For Christmas, my sister brought me a new fan. For Christmas, I brought myself a new vacuum.
I've been binge-watching King of the Hill, and I am literally obsessed. Due to the global pandemic, I'm still working from home, and I honestly feel like I can never work in an office ever again. I scanned my MacBook again, and there were no viruses. And I've been trying this new skincare routine that has got me feeling lovely. So that's a plus. Thank you for watching this segment. I really hope you guys enjoy that segment. Let me know if you want to see more segments like that. I have a few ideas of little segments that I want to put in estrogen release. And if you like it, give this video a thumbs up, comment, leave a comment. But now let's get to the real reason I wanted to put out this video. I just wanted to come on here and say, in the year of 2021, stop comparing yourself to others. I know it's easier said than done. It's so easy that I feel like it's natural to us. We have a natural instinct to compare ourselves to other people. It's like an innate feature. We are very visual beings, therefore when we see something, our minds start to race. Some more than others, but me personally, I know that I'm constantly always in my head about what I am, what I'm putting off, what I'm creating, what I'm doing, all of that. I recently came across this YouTube video about photo editing. I wanted to, you know, learn some new things, kind of enhance my pictures, and I was kind of shook after finished watching it. It was a bomb video. I learned a lot, and I'm definitely probably going to use some of the techniques that she used, but it had me thinking. I was reminded that Instagram and what we see online and social media is so fake. And again, this is no shade towards that girl who, you know, made the video. The video was bomb. However, you know, she did so many things to the picture. I'm thinking it's just a regular schmegler, put a camera in front of the light, boom, boom, boom. But she altered her nose, she altered her lips, and it wasn't in an unnatural way. The scary part was, it was so natural. It was like, and so it kind of made me think like, dang, all of this stuff is a low-key an illusion. Like, we all know when bodies are super enhanced, or, you know, somebody's skin is coming off as darker, or we all know those type Facetune, we all know those type of edits. But when I feel like it's more mind-blowing when it looks hella natural versus the ones that's like, obviously you enhanced the photo, but it's the ones that look mad natural that kind of throw me off. And when I say throw me off, it's not that I think it's a bad thing. I think that, you know, you want to put your best content out there. That's like me telling people, oh, don't wear makeup because it's not natural, when at the end of the day, if you want to look enhanced, do what makes you feel good. I'm saying it in a sense where we're comparing ourselves and thinking that, you know, oh, this person who looks like this, in all actuality, they just enhance the photo to kind of alter their appearance to a certain extent. And so we're basically comparing ourselves to an illusion. Again, I'm not trying to say don't edit your pictures. I'm not trying to say don't edit your pictures. Do what makes you happy. I mean, of course, don't be misleading, but do your thing. Me personally, I'm just trying to encourage you all not to fall for those illusions. Like I said earlier, as a content creator, I'm always comparing myself to others. Sometimes it can be very beneficial because it can be inspo. It can be kind of a motivator to step my game up. It can have all those advantages, but the major disadvantage is that it could be discouraging because I don't look like them, or my quality doesn't look like them, or I just don't, it's not giving me the same vibe as their picture. So I'm just like, wait. After I saw that video, I'm just like, what I'm seeing is not even real. And of course, there's a space where you can kind of take it too far, and then there's a space where you just do a little bit of enhancing, but all in all, it's just not real. So why am I comparing myself to these fake images or these slightly altered images, me trying to be perfect when perfection doesn't exist? Y'all feel me? Y'all get what I'm saying? Because I feel like I don't want to come off as like I'm ranting. I'm just really trying to encourage you guys to not fall for the illusions. Don't fall for the illusions and don't get discouraged, because that's where I was. I was getting discouraged. I'll see somebody's content and I'm like, dang, this person looks bomb. Why my lighting don't look like that? Why my makeup not looking like that? Why is the, you know,
why
I'm feeling down in the dumps. I'm feeling discouraged. I'm feeling like I don't want to create anymore because this illusion of perfection is making me feel this way. Like, no, stop that. Don't compare yourself to other people. And again, it's easier said than done. I'm not going to sit up here and make it seem like I'm just so free and I just love everything that I create and I'm so proud of my work. It's a process. I'm growing in that area. I'm trying to be better. I'm trying to remind myself it's all an illusion to a certain extent, but at the same time that I'm on the same path as them. They're on the same path as me, just of trying to produce the best quality content. So with that being said, sorry for this little rant, you guys. I really want to have more conversations about social media, and because social media is such a huge part in our lives now. I want to say it's inevitable because clearly there's people who totally detach themselves from social media. But at the same time, I want to do this for a living one day, so it's kind of like, these are the issues that I'm always going to come up against. With that being said, thank you for watching. If you're watching, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you on the next video. Peace. Bye.
They're taking a pure electric signal and sculpting it into something of beauty.